So, hello Manohar, how are you?
Yes, sir. I'm fine, sir.
Can you please increase the volume of your PC?
Now, sir.
Now it is better. Okay. Okay,
Yes, sir.
so how are you doing today?
Sir, fine, sir.
Okay, so can you tell me something about yourself?
Yes, sir. My name is Manohar. And I'm from Bangalore Rural District near Nandi Hills. And I also done BE graduation at JB Institute of Technology in Bangalore. And I also done a Java and testing course at ABC Training Center. And coming to my family, my father is a farmer and my mother is a housemaker. And my sister got married. Presently now I'm staying in my native village, sir.
Okay. So, what is the difference between smoke testing and sanity testing?
Sir, smoke testing is testing the basic and critical feature of an application, sir. If the basic and critical feature of an application work fine, means the testing is easy, sir. After white box testing, we will go for smoke testing, sir. Sanity testing means testing the fixed bug of the testing the fixed bug, sir, which do not affect to the Which will do not affect the updated features. Like if you order had any delete features, it does not affect the old features. It is a subset of regression testing, sanity testing. In smoke testing, we will do only positive testing, sir. In sanity testing, we will do both positive and negative. But in smoke testing, it can be automated. In sanity testing, it cannot be automated, sir. In smoke testing, yes, sir.
Okay. See, smoke testing is testing for that is a basic verification check that we are doing on the
Yes,
build.
sir. Yes,
That is the build verification
sir.
check. On a very high level testing
Very
we are doing. That is when you get the
very.
build
Yes,
from the
sir.
developer. And you can see
Yes,
there
sir.
are some 10 items listed in the email notification that these are the
Yes,
items
sir.
to be
Yes.
tested. So you'll be testing on a very high level
Yes.
that whether it is good to go for testing or not. While sanity testing is known as detail level testing, in-depth testing.
Detail
You'll be
level
testing
testing.
each and everything.
In-depth.
That is the main
Yes, sir.
difference between smoke testing and sanity testing.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Sanity testing.
Okay.
It's
Now, what is the difference?
smoke testing is, sir.
Yes, Manohar, please go ahead.
Example like in smoke testing, we will do. He will check. Take an example. Doctor checking to a patient. He will check using blood pressure, BP. It's like smoke testing, sir. In sanitary testing, he will test. Doctor will testing the patient in detail, like heart testing. He will go into the detail heart specialization like that, sir. Detail testing is called sanity testing, sir.
Okay. So, what do you mean by inheritance in Java?
Sir, inheritance means acquiring the properties and behaviors from the parent class to the child class. Using extend keyword, we will extract all the properties from the parent class to the child class is called inheritance, sir. In
Okay.
inheritance, there are three types: single level inheritance, multi-level inheritance, and architecture level inheritance, sir. Multiple inheritance can't be possible, sir. It can be achieved in interface, sir. Single level inheritance means one class is if A is a parent class, B is a child class. Single level B child class acquiring properties from the parent class A, sir. In architecture level means parent class, only A is a parent class, B, C, D, E, F are the child classes, sir. All child classes acquiring properties from only single class is called A parent class. It is called architecture level inheritance. Multi-level inheritance, A, B, C, D, it like it go on A, B, C, D. There are four classes, sir. A is a parent class of B, and B is a parent class of C, sir. And C is a parent class of D. It's a multi-level inheritance.
Correct. So what do you mean by this stored procedures, and how will you use them?
Inheritance, sir.
Sorry, not inheritance, stored procedure.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. What do you mean by stored procedure? Am I audible?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Stored procedure, sir.
Yeah. So it is related to SQL. Yeah, SQL. It is related to SQL. Yeah.
Stored procedure.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not getting, sir.
Okay, no problem. So it is nothing but a collection of SQL statements that can be used as a function to access the database. Okay, it is the stored procedures are generally used to reduce network traffic and improve performance, basically. Okay, so this is related to the SQL thing. So sometimes whenever you will get some applications to be tested and database testing has to be done, so you can use these stored procedures over there. Okay, now let's say if you get a scenario to test a database. Okay, so what all things you will be testing in, you will be doing in database testing?
The voice is not clear.
Yes. Yeah. Is it clear now?
Your voice, sir.
Is it clear now?
Yes.
Now is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So I'm asking, what
yes,
do
sir, now it's clear. Sir.
Yeah. So I'm asking what all things you will check in the database testing.
Database testing, sir.
Yeah.
In database testing, if we send take an example, Facebook application.
Mm-hmm.
If I will enter a username and password,
mm-hmm.
I will register first, sir.
Mm-hmm.
I will register the Facebook application. It will store in the database, sir. First, mm-hmm. first it will store in the database. After registration, then I will go with login, sir. If I will enter login, use a valid username and valid password, and I will click on login button, and it will go, if I enter valid login button is, it will go to the database and it will check, sir, whether the login credit, the matching credential is okay, means it will show home page of the Facebook, sir. It is also database.
Okay.
And data.
So, okay. So let me intervene over here. So what all things you are actually going to test in database? You are doing first registration, you are doing then login. So what all things you are supposed to do in database testing?
By transferring large volume of data.
Yeah. Okay.
Is the database is supported or not?
Mm-hmm.
And
okay. Do you want me to help you?
Yes, sir.
Okay. See, basically in database testing, we are testing whether the connectivity of the database and the application is proper or not. Then we can, stop the, if any service is there, let's say SQL is there. So we can stop the service or we can change the port, and then we can check what is the response in the application. Is it throwing a user-friendly message or some error message is coming or some exception is coming altogether? So those all things are to be tested. So this was about database connectivity. Yes. Then we would be checking about the constraints. What are all the different constraints? So all the permutations and combinations related to the constraints we will be checking. Then required application field and its size. So you were mentioning about the registration page, the home page, login page. So whichever fields are there, like username is there, password is there. So how many characters it is going to get, it is going to accept. Mm-hmm. And if it is, going to get encrypted, then is it the data is going to get encrypted using AES 256 algorithm or something like that? Encryption is happening in the database, that is data at rest or not. Then about the stored procedures, we just, discussed one question prior. Then data retrieval and processing with the DML operations. Then what is the functional flow? So all those things we would be testing in the data. We would be taking care in the database testing. Okay. Fine. So what is inner join?
The inner join is switching all the records from the only matching records from the both the tables, sir. If table A and table B is there, means
mm-hmm.
it returns all the records, only matching records from the tables, sir.
Mm-hmm.
It's called inner join.
Okay, but there is also one more condition for inner join. Are you able to recall it? You are right. The answer is partially right. You know, the inner join is nothing but a simple join, which will return the rows from both the tables. Okay. Now mm-hmm. there is one more condition. What is that? If you are able to recall.
Not getting, sir.
Okay. No problem. So it will return all the rows from both the tables, and it should have at least one matching column. Both the tables. Okay. There should be one matching column, then it will fetch you all the rows.
Okay.
Okay. Right. So, what is the difference between union and union all?
Sir, union means it will return only matching. If two tables is there, means it will return both the values.
So union is actually, you know,
combining two tables.
Sorry, remove the
combining two or more tables.
Yeah, that is there.
Yes, sir.
And it will also remove the duplicate rows, right? Union.
Yes, sir, duplicate.
While union all would it be able to remove the duplicate rows?
Sir, no, sir. Using distinct keyword, we can remove duplicate rows.
Yeah. Correct. Okay. Can you tell me, you know, the high level test scenarios for a login page?
Yes, sir.
Mm-hmm.
Login page, sir. Test scenarios.
Yeah. Login page scenarios. High level test scenarios.
Sir, testing the verify the login functionality of an application.
Mm-hmm.
And both positive or negative scenarios, sir.
Sorry?
Sir, I should have to take both positive or negative scenarios?
Yeah. All the scenarios, whether they are positive, negative, security testing point of view, performance testing point of view, whichever are coming to your mind, you can tell.
Login credential. Login for valid username and valid password.
Mm-hmm.
And I will click on button. It will redirect into home page, sir. In negative scenario, I will enter username correct and password is wrong, invalid password, and I will click on button. It should show you have entered the wrong password. Please try again. It should show like that, sir. When I enter valid username and invalid password. When I entered valid username and invalid username and invalid password, it should show. Hello, sir.
Yeah. Yes, please go ahead. I think there was some interconnect. Yeah. Okay, you were telling about valid username and valid password.
Yes, a valid user. I will enter valid username, valid password. It will log into the application successfully, sir. When another. I will enter a valid username and invalid password.
Mm-hmm.
It should show. Please try again. You are entered wrong password. Like that, it should show, sir. And I will enter both invalid username and invalid password. It should show you entered both the username and password is wrong. Please try again. It should show like that, sir. And when I click on the login button should be work, sir. and I will check the username text field is correct or not, and the password text field text is correct or not, and in password it should first letter is a capital letter, and the password should... Hello, sir, I'm audible?
Yes, Manohar, please go ahead.
Yes, sir, and I will check login button, and I will check password text field, and I will check username, and yes, sir, this is login.
Okay. Now, can you tell me the test scenarios from a security testing point of view?
Security testing point of view, sir.
Mm-hmm.
If I when I enter login password and login valid password and invalid username, when it will log into successfully, then its security is not good, sir. When I enter valid username and invalid password,
then that is a functional issue.
Yes,
right, the functionality itself is not working. If you enter any of the invalid credentials, invalid username or invalid password, the functionality itself is not working.
Yes, sir. And
from a security testing,
in security testing, I will say, sir, in security testing, when I enter a valid password and a valid username, and I will click on login button, and it will go to home, login to the successfully. Then I will copy the URL of the URL, sir. Then I will paste it on the notepad, and I will log out from the login Gmail application, sir. I will log out from the Gmail application. When I paste it on the URL in the notepad, no, sir. Again, I copy that URL and I will paste it on another Google website. When I enter it, it should show. Please enter your username and password, like that. It should show, sir. If it is login to the successfully, means the security is not good, sir. It's URL manipulation.
Okay, so you mean to say you are playing with a caching of the application?
It's a URL manipulation.
That is whether the username and password are stored in the cache or not.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Okay. So let me help you over here. So whenever you get this question, like, you know, from a security testing point of view,
yes, sir.
So you have to make sure that your credentials are not compromised.
Yes, sir.
Your credentials should not be in a plain text.
Yes.
Now, how will you make that thing to be, you know, sure from your end? What you can do is, there is a tool called Hex Editor. So you can perform login with a valid credentials, valid username and valid password into the application. And you can take the dump of your browser, whether it is Chrome browser or IE browser, from the task manager. And the Hex Editor, you can open that dump file into the Hex Editor.
Mm-hmm.
And you can search for your username and password.
Yes,
so it should not be displayed in a plain text. It should be encrypted. Okay, any encryption algorithm should be used by the developer. So you can search, if your username was Manohar and your password was 128. So when you open that dump file into Hex Editor application, you can search for your name Manohar or 128. And if you're able to find it in the plain text itself, it means your credentials are compromised. Okay, so that is a security testing bug. Another thing what you can do is, let's say you are trying to log in. You enter username,
can
you enter password,
sir?
You click on login button. Yes, yes, Manohar. Am I audible?
Sir, when entering the password, the data hiding should be there, sir. When I enter the password, it should show star, star, star button like that. So it is also
right. Right. It should not be in a plain text. That is from a, you know, obvious. That is GUI thing that should be encrypted. Now, I was talking about man in the middle attack. Okay, what happens in that? You have got some tools like Fiddler. The role of Fiddler is that it would, you can play with the request on the go. So let's say if you are entering username, and if you are entering password, you are clicking on the login button.
Mm-hmm.
Now you break that request and you try to modify that request. Okay, and you change your password or you enter invalid username, and then you click on go, and then you allow that request to be served by the server. Then the response should be error message should come. It should not allow you to log in, because on the fly during the request, you have played with those parameters and you have manipulated it. So it should give you a proper error message. Okay. So these are all the security testing bugs that you should find out. And why it is called man in the middle attack? Because it is also known as MMA. So using Fiddler, we are trying to manipulate the request. Okay, we are entering positive parameters at the beginning, but in the middle, we are trying to hack it. The hackers generally, they do in the same way, right? They'll be playing with the Wi-Fi passwords and all those things. So you have to address these things. And then from the performance testing point of view, you can also tell, let's say if there are 10 users, so 10 concurrent users are trying to log in into the application, 10 different valid users.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Then the application should not break. Everyone should be able to see the page within quick turnaround time. It should not, that page should not get loaded for a lot of time, like, because 10 concurrent users were testing it. 10 is just an example. You can do the testing with 50, 100,000 users, performance testing scenarios. Okay. So these things you have to take care. Now I'll share my screen.
Okay.
And I have got few multiple choice questions.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Are you able to see the screen?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Is the screen visible?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. It's visible.
Okay. Okay. So I have given you, two stages over here. One is SDLC, software development lifecycle. Another is testing lifecycle. Okay. So you have to now these are the activities, high level design, coding, low level design, business requirements. These are the activities of SDLC, software development lifecycle. And these are the activities of testing lifecycle, unit test, acceptance test, system test, integration test. Now you have to match the correct activity of SDLC with the correct activity of the testing lifecycle. So the mapping of the phases. So any one of the option out of these four options would be true. So which option will you go for? Are you able to understand the question?
Yes, sir, I'm able to understand. Sir, I should have to match with the both the conditions, sir.
Yeah, you have to match. Let's say if high level design is there, so which option will it go for? A, B, C, or D? So accordingly,
okay, sir. Okay.
And other options. Then for the other option, which testing phase would be performed? Then low level design is there. And so what testing phase would be performed? So business requirements. What is the testing phase? So accordingly, you have to tell.
Okay, sir.
Yeah. Do you want me to help you?
Yes, sir. Shall I tell, sir?
Yeah. Please tell. I am waiting for you.
Yes, sir.
So you have to map the phase of the stage of the SDLC with the testing life cycles. A, B, C, and D are the testing life cycle phases, and 1, 2, 3, 4 Roman numbers are the SDLC phases, SDLC activities. So any one of these four options is right, is correct. Shall I reveal the answer? Hello. Okay. Manohar, shall I reveal the answer?
Sir, I think A is the correct answer. I think so, sir.
D?
B, B, sir.
Which one you are telling? D or B?
B.
B.
B, sir.
B you are telling?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so B is first means high level design. Is C, high level design with system test. Okay, this is the right answer. Then second will go with D, coding will go with integration test. Are you sure this coding phase will involve integration test?
No, sir. Unit testing, sir.
Unit testing, right? So second will be A,
yes,
right? But it is D.
Yes, sir.
So B cannot be the right answer. The right answer over here is D.
Yes, sir. Yes.
C, second code will be going with the unit test. Then you have got low level design that would go with integration test. And at the end, we have got business requirements. So we would be doing acceptance testing. Okay. So right answer will be D over here. Got it? See, D is the right answer. Okay. Now, kickoff phase of a formal review includes the following. Now, which of these things are involved in a kickoff phase? A, B, C, or D?
Sir, I am not getting, sir, this one.
Okay. So kickoff phase is nothing but, you know, it is a part of a formal review. And basically the purpose is you have to explain the object. So the right answer is A. Okay. Okay. Now consider the following statements. You must be aware about statement coverage, branch coverage, and decision coverage, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So which one of these statements are true? 100% statement coverage guarantees 100% branch coverage, 100% branch coverage guarantees 100% statement coverage, or 100% branch coverage guarantees 100% decision coverage, or decision coverage to branch coverage vice versa, or statement coverage guarantees decision coverage. So which one of these options is true? A, that is, you know, two is true, and first, third, fourth, and fifth are false, or B, first and fifth are true, second, third, and fourth are false, or C, second and third statement out of these statements are true, first, fourth, and fifth are false, or D, second, third, and fourth are true, first and fifth are false.
Sir, what is the meaning of statement coverage and branch coverage, sir?
Okay, are you aware about this, what is branch coverage and what is statement coverage?
No, sir.
Manohar?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So branch coverage is nothing but, you know, based on the various decisions, based on the various conditions into the program, the test cases would be defined. Let's say if there is a if condition. So if x is greater than y, so y is a greater number. Else, y is a smaller number. So whatever the conditions are there, based on that, you will be taking the decision. Okay, so that is a branch coverage. So you'll be covering all the branches. Okay. Similarly, you have got decision coverage and you have got statement coverage. So if you are not comfortable with these coverage things, so they are basically used to define the test cases. Let's say if you have got a requirement, so based on this coverage sections, you will be writing the test cases.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So let me move to the next question. Then the right answer is this last one. First and fifth are false. 100% okay. Statement coverage guarantees 100% branch coverage. This is a false statement. And 100% statement coverage guarantees decision coverage. So this is also a false statement.
Okay.
Okay. Now tests are prioritized so that now you might be, let's say if you have got 20 test cases to be tested and you have got very less time. Now you think I should test this 5 test cases. So on what basis you will be prioritizing your test? So you shorten the time required for testing. You do the best testing in the time available. You do more effective testing. You find more false or none of the above. Which is the right answer?
You shorten it. Sir, one or two, sir. Option A or option B, I think so.
Yeah. Option A or option B. Which one is the right answer? You are close to the answer.
You are short on the thing. You do best testing in the time available, sir.
Best testing in the time available, right? Yeah, that is the correct answer. You do the best testing in the time available. Now, you shorten the time required for testing is not a solution, right? If you don't have the time, then you should tell to the stakeholders, you should tell to the management that you need more time to test. You cannot,
if you cannot
shorten the time, right? Just on the priority test cases, because you have other functionality and features also to be tested. So you do the best testing in the time available is the right answer. Now, equivalence class partitioning is, one of the and boundary value analysis. So these are the black box testing techniques. Now you have to identify the invalid equivalence class value. So consider there is a field on a form which contains a text box and it should accept alphabets in a lower or upper case. Okay.
Okay, sir.
So what would be the invalid equivalence class value out of this A, B, C, D? Which one is the invalid equivalence class value?
Invalid, sir.
Yeah, invalid. You have to find the invalid one.
Option A, sir.
Sorry?
Option A.
A. How come option A?
Sir, the alphabets accept lower or upper case, sir. Here in option B, one C is a, we are in C letter is a lower case. And LASS are upper case, sir. It is all test files are passed. In option C, CL is uppercase and AAS is both are passed here also. In D, CL is uppercase, A small s is lowercase, here also passed. But in option A, only uppercase is there, sir. There is no lowercase. That's why it is invalid, sir.
Okay. Now see, it is written which accepts alphabets in lower or uppercase. Right? So it is a optional thing, either lower or either uppercase.
Okay.
So it might accept all the lower, it might accept all the uppercase. So this is a valid class. Okay. This is also a valid class. This is also a valid class. Now, what would be the problem with this? It would contain numeric value 0 and 1. So this is the invalid one. Okay. See, this is the invalid one. Okay. Now, impact analysis helps us to decide A, B, C, or D.
Regression testing.
Yeah, regression testing. You are close to the answer. But which one, D or A? Okay, shall I help you?
I think different tools to perform regression
no,
testing.
It would, the right answer is how much regression testing should be done. See, tools and all these things would be taken care by the expertise of your test managers or teams are there. But
yes, sir.
Basically, how much is the defect going to impact the code? Okay, let's say if you found out some defect and the developer is telling that based on the analysis, you have to, you know, test all these things. So that is where the regression testing will play a vital role. Okay, so how much testing should be done is the right answer. Right?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, do you know about peer reviews?
Sir?
Peer
review system, sir? No,
peer
sir.
Peer reviews?
No, sir.
Okay, so these are nothing but, you know, reviews done by the another member. So those are also yes, called as technical review.
Technical review. Okay.
Yeah. Okay. So these were a few of the, you know, manual testing questions, which you will get in the interviews as well. And these questions were, you know, very straightforward, but the options were a bit confusing just to check the knowledge on the very right basis. Okay. So thank you, Manohar, for joining us. It was nice talking to you. I think almost 45 minutes, right?
Yes, sir.
So it was nice talking to you. Yeah. Let me know if you have any questions for me. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Sir, I'm giving all the interviews, but so many, they're not shortlisting. Why I'm not understanding?
Just a second.
Technical.
Yeah, what are you telling?
Given so many technical interviews, sir.
Uh-huh.
They're not shortlisting. What is the feedback of the interview, sir?
Okay.